We've had our robot vacuum cleaner about a year now, and there are some hints and tricks to make it operate more reliably, and more reliably is one of the key things so that it doesn't get stuck and call you and not finish the room and so forth. We have found it's more of a luxury item. It helps keep dust down between cleanings. And we've also found some general things like it works better on a harder floor like wood, tile, something like that. Works okay on these short carpets. And a good room preparation is also necessary, so I can tell you some of the things to look out for that it'll snag on. So let me show you those. As you can see, this window ledge is a full-length window. That's called an inch and a half high. Just a little too short for it to see, and it catches on it, and that's one of those spots where it snags. So how do you keep your robot from sticking on here? You can just put your shoes on there, and it will see the shoes and not get stuck up there. Furniture with legs like this, with this slope to it, is a good trap for these things. It dries up on here and then gets stuck, as you can see. So with these are some small tables. We just pick them up and turn them upside down on the couch. But any kind of ramp, I'll show you some more of these where it likes to get stuck on. Here's another place she likes to get hung up on. It's the ironing board. And it's just these front legs. The back legs, for some reason, are at a slightly different angle. It won't hang her up, and she'll drive up here and get stuck. So typically the way we address this is put the ironing board away. To deal with the ironing board legs, I thought about just putting a piece of duct tape across here. Doesn't look beautiful, but it's just an ironing board, right? But I'm trying to come up with a more glamorous way of doing it, some kind of a maybe just even tape a piece of paper or plastic across here so they can see the leg more easily and stop. Here's another one of her favorite hang-ups. You can't see it, but she's got the doorstop. She pulled the doorstop out front of the door, and there it is. So most of the time she gets hung up on it, and we have to come and free her. But removing the doorstop is typically the right answer. She also likes to get hung up underneath this clothes rack, as you can see. So again, the clothes rack has to be moved. She's coming after me. She's mad. To keep her from dragging this thing around, I'm thinking about some way to lift it up. It only needs to go up like millimeters, and it would pass right underneath it. So trying to think of a way to lengthen the legs. I've got another one of these with adjustable legs. I adjust them all the way down and it'll pass right underneath it. So it's something like, you know, millimeters, half an inch, whatever. And that's one fix for this. The other fix is just to move it out of the way. Another way to keep the robot from hanging up on this is to provide a visual barrier. I mean, simply you could take a piece of duct tape and put it across here and hang a piece of duct tape down here and it would stop. Or you could do something more beautiful. You could get like a little fabric thing and sew it over there so that when the robot comes up and sees it, it will stop and not get jammed underneath there. So those are other options. So you can lift it up or you can create a visual barrier and the robot won't go underneath there. Here's another place where it sometimes gets stuck is on the leg of our electronic piano. This time it cleared it, but a lot of times it'll get stuck on there. So again, you can just set something up on top of the leg, like up here, set something on top of it so it can see it, and it'll stop before it gets there. Carpets aren't too bad, a heavy carpet, as long as it doesn't have these tassels on it. So So if you got a heavy carpet like this, you can leave it down, pick it up. I usually pick it up, but if it's got tassels on it, it'll tangle in there, so you gotta pick those up. This kind of carpet's not too bad. It doesn't have any frills on the edges. Doesn't do a great job with it, but does an okay job. As long as it's a heavier carpet, edges won't come up. It'll do okay. Cords are oftentimes an issue. The phone cord almost always gets stuck on it. We normally have it tucked up in here. I'll show you that. Internet cable. Oftentimes we get away with the internet cable being down there. These big heavy-duty extension wires that we use for the computers, the extension cords for the computers. Usually not a problem. It'll jump over it, but as you can see back in the corner, it also doesn't clean the dust around it. So, cords. Let me show you how I deal with some of them, but typically you have to get them off the floor. So back behind the desk, what I've done is just put a hook on here and hung the wires and use some of those Velcro tabs, get the phone and internet wires up off the floor so that the robot can get underneath the desk and not get snagged up on wires. We've also found that spacing furniture just right will allow her to get back in the corners. In this case, we have to push the vanity stool over so she can fit inside this opening, and then she'll go in there and clean it. The same is true on spacing of like that cabinet over there between the bed and the cabinet. She can't get in that little crack, so we usually move that cabinet over, usually leave it over, so that she can get around it. Also, leaving a door open like this, if you can, will allow it to clean behind the door so that you don't move the door and suddenly find dust bunnies behind it. So, but again, leaving a door open like that will allow the robot to get behind it. It's best to move things like this small trash can out of her way. Most of the time it'll see it and stop, but oftentimes she'll just start pushing it around the floor. Another thing to consider are small things like this. We have this little bump right here between storage room and the hallway out there. And she'll make it over this, and then she'll even convince herself she can go down into the storage room. I think this was originally designed to be a bathroom or something, but anyhow, it has a step down. She'll get over this, and then she'll get down here, and she'll get out into the storage room. And she can't get back, of course. She'll clean the storage room, but doesn't get the rest of the floor done. So we just simply shut this door right here and let her do that hallway out in there and the rooms that are attached, and then let her do the storage room separately. Another thing to consider in your room preparation is to make sure that you don't have something that's tippy like this that has liquid, something hot, glass that'll break. Because there's sometimes when the robot bumps into stuff, it'll rock and stuff will tip and fall off. So when you're doing your room preparation, consider things like this that can tip and cause damage or problems. When you're preparing your room, you also want to look around for things like this that are easily tipped over, that are expensive, like your camera on a tripod. It would be a bad idea to leave this thing sitting here and run the robot. It would easily tip it over and you might end up with an expensive thing. So when you're preparing your room, look for things that can tip over and break other things, brooms, mops, anything like that that will tip over and maybe strike something else. So